in nature, we're surrounded by all these amazingly beautiful animals. Crazy songs, crazy colors and dances, overpowering odors. These traits evolve because they're attractive to members of the opposite sex. My colleagues and I have been studying this very inconspicuous frog, the Tungara frog, for the last 30 years, looking at their behavior and their brains and their evolution. When they call, the males are calling to attract females, and we know that the females are more attracted to calls with more chucks. So when the males keep adding these beautiful sounding syllables, these chucks, the reason they're doing that is they're competing for mates. But these chucks are also attractive to other animals. The frog-eating bat eats Tungara frogs, and the way that it finds them is by listening to their call. And if the bats have a choice between going to a call that has chucks versus one that doesn't have chucks, the bats go to the call with chucks. So we think that in both cases, adding chucks to the call makes the males more conspicuous to females, but unfortunately for them, it also makes them more conspicuous to the frog-eating bats. On the one hand, making the traits more complex, more elaborate, more beautiful, increases their chance of getting a mate, but it also increases their chances of becoming a meal. What we've shown is that Darwin was very correct in suggesting that female mate choice was this very important selection force causing the evolution of these beautiful as well as deadly traits.